Today, I'm going to discuss managing your global configuration file or folder, what we commonly refer to as a GCF. I'm going to discuss how to open, save, as well as email one of the files. I'm also going to discuss what actually comprises a global file. We're going to talk about some of the differences between different variations of software between V1, V2, V3, as well as V4, and how to identify what version software you have. I'm going to talk about the minimum ICFs or individual configuration files that are actually required to comprise a global folder and get an engine to start. We're going to discuss for the more advanced user how to export global configuration files into the individual library of ICFs, as well as how to create a global folder by importing those files back out. Also going to discuss how to look at an existing global folder and determine what ICFs were used to compile it in the first place. Let's go ahead and take a look at the software. We'll get started. Starting with, what does GCF stand for? Prior to V4, GCF was an acronym for Global Configuration Folder. With V4, it stands for Global Configuration File. Your software version can be identified by the first digit in the software. To identify your software version, open the software, then click on the Help dropdown. Then click on About Holley EFI. The software version will be noted in the lower right-hand corner. This image shows examples for V1 through V4 variants. Managing these files has evolved through different software versions, and I'm going to run through some of the key points of each, with opening and saving a global file with V1 software variants. The GCF in V1 was a global folder. To open a global folder in V1, click File, then Open Global Folder. If your laptop does not automatically bring up the global folder options, you may need to manually browse to this folder. V1 global folders are located in a Holley folder on the C drive. It's located under Program Files x86. You'll do this by opening your file library and selecting your C drive, then Program Files x86. Open the Holley folder and the global folders, then select the global file you want to open and click OK. The global file will show in upper left-hand corner of your software screen. To create and save a new global folder name in V1, click File and Save Global Folder As. To save it as a new name, you'll need to create a new directory path. You will do this by typing a backslash, the new folder name, at the end of the directory path. I'll call this one Test. You will then click OK to save the folder. A new window will pop up that says that this folder does not exist. Do you want to create it? Simply select Yes. If you find that you cannot save the file, you need to make sure that your Windows security settings have permission set that will allow you to write to the folder. You can check this by right-clicking the Holley folder that contains your V1 program files. Select Properties, then Security. Next, look at your user ID. If your user ID does not have write privileges, you'll need to add them. You may need to have admin access on the PC to change these settings. A significant change to folder management occurred with the release of V2. The global folders, ICF library, and data log folders were removed from the program files and relocated to the documents folder. To open a global, click File and Open Global File. As you can see, compared to V1, the layout has changed. You can open your subfolders to view available global files, and by clicking the Home tab, it will take you back to the main directory. You may want to browse to a different location. To choose to create a new directory, click on the Choose or Create a New Directory tab. This will allow you to browse to a different location. To open a global folder, simply locate the file that you want to open and double-click the file. You'll now see the main file name at the top corner of the screen. To save a new folder, go to File, Save global folder as, then select your desired directory. Next, you'll type the new name at the bottom of the screen and click Save. Like V1, a window will ask you if you want to create it. Just go ahead and click Yes. Let's take a deeper look at V1 through V3 global folders. I'm going to go to my Documents and open a Holley HEFI folder. I'm going to select Global Folders. I'm going to pick a global folder to look at a little bit further. When I open a particular global folder, I will see all of the ICFs that comprise that given global folder. If you need to email a global folder, you'll need to compress it and send it as a zipped file. To do this, simply right-click on the folder that you want to send. Go down to Send To, then click Compress Zip Folder. You will then see a zip file at the bottom of the window. You can right-click and send this file to an email recipient. Or you can copy and paste it to an email. Then simply hit Send. Here's a global folder management tip. You never want to change the folder name by right-clicking the folder and selecting Rename. Renaming an existing folder to a name that is different than the .gcf file contained within the folder will break the file. You could change the .gcf file in the folder as well to correct this, but let's just keep it simple. If you want to change the file name, the easiest way to do this is to simply open the file and save it as a different name. You can then save and send it as required. Let's take a look at some changes that came with the release of V4. Prior to V4, GCF was an acronym for Global Configuration Folder. With V4, the file convention has changed. It's changed from a window-based folder to a Holley HEFI file, and it now stands for Global Configuration File. If you have V4 software, go to Documents, Holley HEFI V4, and look in the Global File folder. You will find that the Windows-based folders of previous versions are no longer present, and they've been replaced by .hefi files, as well as a corresponding text document. The text document will tell you what ICFs are used to compile the global file. You can now email a GCF by simply attaching the .hefi file to an email. There is no need to send a text document, as one will be created automatically when you save the file. Opening a global file in V4 is the same as it was in V2 and V3 versions. However, saving a global file is a little different. When you go to Save As, you will see this window. You can select your directory path at the top and enter your new file name at the bottom. Then select Save. Here is a V4 GCF tip. If you save a V4 GCF to your desktop, you'll need to create a new folder on the desktop to place it in. Then save the GCF in that folder. Otherwise, the software will not be able to find the file when you try to open it. At a minimum, a GCF requires the core 5 individual configuration files or ICFs before the engine can start. These include fuel, sensor, system, idle, and the Spark ICF. Additional ICFs such as transmission control can be added or removed as required. This combination of ICFs creates the GCF. For the more advanced user, you can create a global folder by selecting a la carte ICFs. To do this, select File, then Create New Global File. The system will require you to select the core 5 ICFs for fuel, sensor, idle, system, and Spark. You can then add additional ICFs as desired and save the global file as you see fit. You may find that you've modified some ICFs and you want the ability to add them to your a la carte ICF library. You can do this by clicking on File, then Export GF to Library ICFs. You can then select and label them how you desire. I'm going to label a couple of these A and then click OK. Now I'm going to create a new global. As you can see, A is now an available option to choose from. If you want to see what ICFs compile your current global folder or file, simply click File and Global File or Folder Properties. When you're tuning, it's important to periodically save the global file as you're making improvements to the program. This way you have a recent backup to fall back on and will not need to start from scratch in the event that you make a mistake. It's a good practice to alternate between a couple different file names. This concludes our lesson on GCF management.
For more helpful Holley tech tips and videos, go to Holley.com.